Welcome back, everybody. We're back today with episode 6 of my tips and tricks series, and in this one we're going to be going over different techniques I use for masking airframes for different camouflage patterns. So hopefully this has got some information that you guys can use, and let's get started. Tips and tricks, episode 6. In this tips and tricks video, I'm going to be going over some of the techniques for masking for camouflage on a general airframe. So I'll be starting with this one here, the Focke-Wulf 198. You've seen this one in a bit of my videos already. So there's a few different ways that you can mask for a camo pattern. The easiest, I would say, in general sense, is with masking tape. So you can see it's just like when you do a canopy. You can see here I've got it done already along this line. Masked off the wing root area. So obviously this area here will stay the bluey gray color, and the wings will get the two-tone gray camo pattern. So the thing you have to remember with tape, it is a little easier to apply. However, it will leave a sharp, sharp edge. So in cases where you don't want a sharp edge, you want to find another way of applying your camo. So in this case, along the top, this will give me the hard edge. The top camo, where it blends with the bottom camo, I want a bit of a softer edge. So what the technique I use is a few different techniques you can do. Freehand is always an option. It's, I guess, in the grand scheme of things, really the easiest way to do it. But it's also hard because you have to have your technique down. Being able to freehand camo in a way that you have even coverage, you follow the pattern perfectly, and you have constant overlap, no sort of super wide blend here and a smaller blend there. It takes a bit of practice. So if you have the time and the effort to sit down and practice it, freehanding is always the easier way to do it because it doesn't involve any prep work other than your bit of masking here in certain areas. So for this model here, I do want to have a little bit of a softer edge across the top. So I'm going to use a technique using this stuff. This is the Blue Tack. You can get it at most Walmarts or office supply stores, Office Max or Staples or what have you. It's just it's a poster putty. It's the sticky tack. You put a little ball on the back of your poster, stick it to your wall, comes off, doesn't peel paint, etc., etc., etc. It works really well in this situation here. So, for example, I'm going to want to do, following the instructions here, I'm going to do RLM 74. So you can see it's kind of the browny green color here. So you come back to the instructions. This is my ultimate model with the green stripes. Hard to see the underlying camo pattern. So I'll probably copy the camo pattern as seen on this one and just carry it over. So you can kind of see where you're going to go from about the middle of the cowling on this side back to just to the edge of the rear edge of the canopy. So you're going to use your blue tack. And you're going, well, first off, I guess I'll lay the side panel, the side side lines out. So you just kind of stick it to your model. You just apply it, press it down so it kind of adheres to the plastic, and then run it down along the side of your model. So for this case here, I don't have to go all the way because I'm only doing the one color, so I can just apply it to the area that I'm applying it, that I'm painting. So it's nice because you'll see it gives you a natural wavy pattern the way you would if you're painting and kind of giving it. So it adds that automatically. If you need to make a little bit of a difference, let's say you have an area where you need a bit of a bump out, you can just use your thumb here and you can just kind of push it. And you can see you can apply and you can make it what you need. You can play with it. You can give it tight corners if you need it. You know, you can mold it the way you want, the same way you would mold any type of putty. So you can give it the shape you want. I prefer to just have that natural look. If you leave it as like a sausage, when you paint straight off, because of the little lip, you get a nice soft feathered edge to your camo. If you want a sharper, obviously a sharper edge, then you would want to use tape. It's a lot easier than trying to make this a nice sharp edge. So you just kind of, you want to make sure that you have nice, an even sort of diameter. And I'll just go to the other side and try to line it up as close as you can. You can see here I'm just below the panel line. So on this side I want to be just below the panel line. And then kind of try to keep it as straight as possible. Excuse me, stupid head cold. No, chest cold at this point. Anyways, just kind of apply it down, keeping, you know, as much the same from side to side as you can. You want it to be more or less even on either side. Alright, so that's that applied. Now I'm going to do the cross pieces. So you just grab a bunch of this stuff. It gets stiff when it's cold, but if you work it with your hands, warm it up, it makes it a lot easier to apply. So I'm going to go across the nose. So you can see on this side, it starts about midway on that cowling panel. So I'm going to go about, oops. The one thing you do have to kind of remember is what side you want to put it on, if you want the seam down the middle of the panel. So if you want, let's get this a little, there we go. So if you want the seam to be sort of mid-panel, you don't put the putty down the middle, because that doesn't put the line where you need it. You need to offset it so that this the line where you want it is going to be. Now, in all reality, I don't have to necessarily run the cross pattern here because I'm only doing the first color. So I'm probably not going to do that. So the first pass you can do with a rough estimate and then tighten it up on the second color and then you join your two colors. So I'm just going to leave it at that for now. And what you'll do, I'm not going to do it now. I'll do it when I actually get into the paint booth to paint. So for example, the wings I'm not too worried about, but what I would do, you have nice thick painter's tape. So this is sort of your standard, what, 1 inch? This is sort of your 2 inch paint. I picked this stuff up at Walmart for like 99 cents a roll. Super cheap, it's a 3M Scotch tape. What you're gonna do is when you're, you know, in the painting booth, you've got your tape, you're just gonna kind of apply your tape onto the putty, and that allows the overspray. So if you paint that line, you're not gonna get overspray on your model. Same thing back here. If I know my paint line is gonna be around the back of the cockpit, I would apply the tape kind of back here, you know, and it makes sure that when I paint that line with the paint tape here, I'm not gonna get any overspray on the undercolor, and I'll clean up that line when I do my second color. So it all balances at the end. So that's kind of the start there of what I'm gonna do with this color. So you'll be able to see that. So I'm gonna go there now, and I'm gonna paint the first color, RLM74, on this section of the fuselage. And then I'll give it a quick hit with the hot air from the blow dryer, and I'll come back and I'll peel off those little sausages, and you'll get to see what she turns out looking like. So stay tuned. Okay, so here we are. I've got that first section of gray painted through the center of the fuselage. Normally I'd pull the tape off at the paint booth where I keep it, but for purposes of this video, I'll show you here. I want to do it here because sometimes a newer piece of sticky tape like this will actually peel that putty off. So you gotta be a little careful when you're doing it. You can see already the glue of the tape is pulling off some of the putty. This is a brand new piece of tape, so it's got a bit more sticky factor. You'll see when I pull the other side off, as you use the tape more, the stickiness becomes less and less, and it's not as much of a problem. You can see on this side it peels off a lot easier. So that's just as you use the tape and you lose the stickiness on the back, it doesn't stick as well, comes off a little easier. So in a case where, for example, you need to keep this in place and do another color, you gotta be very careful taking it off. Luckily, I'll be able to tie into this. I'll show you that when I do the next color, being able to peel these off, but then come back and tie into the same line and make sure that it's a continuous, smooth transition. This also makes it really easy to do that. So, now the moment of truth. I'm going to zoom in here a little bit so you can take a look. So if you look here at the back, you can see an example of where I use tape. You get a very sharp line. And where the putty is, if I peel the putty off, you'll see it leaves a nice soft transition. All right, so it leaves a nice beautiful transition, a natural looking curve. You know, it looks more hand painted than if you just use tape. It'd be very hard to replicate that using tape. So there you go. You can see it's a nice natural looking line. Not quite as sharp as tape, not quite as you know, well, free as freehand. So it allows you to kind of get that in between look that you're looking for in some models. So that's that section. Next, I'll do the tail. So you know, again, when you want to do your tail, just for you know demonstrations purposes, you know, put a piece of tape on the bottom. Well, you'd probably start on the sides. So you'd put a piece sort of tight up against this side. You could put a piece of tape here, slide it up underneath the elevator, so up tight against the fuselage. And then you want to put a piece either across the bottom like that, or you can come in and stick it to the bottom of the elevator, and then you have the ability to paint that elevator, and you won't get any paint overspray onto that. And then when you do the tail, you can mask the tail off as well, and you'd be able to get the rest of it without ruining your line. So you just have to stage it. This section, let it dry. This section, let it dry. That section, let it dry. Work your way in stages. As I've said in previous videos, patience is a must when you're doing something like this to ensure that you get the proper look. So I'm gonna head to the room now. I'll get some of these tails painted up. Gonna start on that, and we'll go from there. So yeah, stay tuned. And there you can see it all ready to go. This one's easy. There's no like extra parts that need to be installed on this, so it's all what you see. So the gray, the first color gray has all been painted, and you can see I've left the areas for the other shade of gray, kind of a lighter color gray, but you can see it there. So you know, I'll go along and I'll mask off the shape that I need, and then I can go through and paint that, and you'll have your nice panel camo lines between everything. So two on each wing plus the top of the nose, and this section on the rear fuselage, which will also include the tails on each side and the insides of the horizontal stabs. So one, you know, first paint line will be probably wingtips, and then so one, two, three, mask all that off in one shot, do the whole tail in four. So another four more stages. One, probably the nose in one of them. So like one, two, three, four, five. Five more paint cycles, and this guy will have all of his camo done. So there you go. That's how you one of the ways you can mask off the fuselage for camo. Nice soft feathered edges. Like I see, it'll look a lot better. It's a little hard to see it now once I get the final color on it, and you start pulling all the masking tape off and everything off, it'll just pop. So you can at least start to see the beginning of it. And then while I've got you here, I'll set up for the next one. So the TA-152 and the Focke-Wulf D9, both are gonna have this green and then this sort of brown. It's called like violet brown. I don't know what the color is actually gonna look like when I use it. Germans had really weird names for their colors. Anyways, so this particular one, I've been doing something a little different. It's the first time I've done this mottled paint on a German aircraft using an airbrush. So you can see there what I'm talking about, the way they had the little bits and pieces of whatnot sticking out. So what I've done, I've actually used paper. I photocopied the instructions, blew it up, cut out the little things. So I just, you know, laid the paper on and taped it off and painted away. So what my plan is for here, and this is going to be sort of the first test of it, is trying to get everything lined up again, and then taping it off and repainting it. So if I get the instructions out, you'll be able to see what it looks like. So the color line comes right around the back of the cockpit, and I'll probably come down between, I kind of have a little overspray on this one. I'm going to come down between these two colors. So I can tape this back here, because that's a section that's going to stay green, right? And then keeping this down nice and tight, you can come to the front and make sure that it lines up on the front little area there. You can see that guy there. So get that lined up. So now I've got that where I want it. I can kind of tape down here, and then I can come up front. And you want to, again, make sure, if you look at the instructions, the camo line comes down just behind that forward hinge line. So if I come up here just behind that, I can tape forward of the hinge line, right? And that'll make sure that when I lay down the now I've only got one. I'll zoom out a little bit. I've only got one. Sorry again. One paper mask, and I've been mirroring because I don't have a picture of what the other side looks like. So I've just been mirroring on the two sides. Most people aren't going to know the difference when they see this in person that it's been mirrored. So, you know, I figure it's okay. So what I'll do is I'll paint this up. I'll kind of mask off on one side, and I'll paint it to just past the halfway point. Flip the mask to this side, mask off on this side, and kind of paint past the overlap, blending it all together. But what I need to do is ensure that I have a soft line between the two colors. So I need to get out my blue tack putty. And as I said, paint line is just at the rear of the canopy. So I want to make sure that I cover, see this hole here I want green, but that one here I want brown. So I'm going to cover this guy with the putty completely, and then I can bring this guy back, cross the rear of that, and then I don't care what happens on this side because I'll blend it in later. So that covers that, and then, you know what, I'm just going to grab the little extra guy off of here, and I got to come to the front and do the same thing. So if I come down, the tape isn't working at all, put that garbage pile, get myself a new piece of tape, make sure I have a nice solid connection there. You know what, just for shits and giggles, I'm going to put a piece of tape across the bottom. There. Now, it comes down just behind the first hinge. So what I think I'm going to do is try to incorporate this. No, I'm not. I'm going to fudge it a little bit just because I want to have at least one green bit behind the cowling. So I'm actually going to cover that one completely. I'm going to bring it back and around. And bring it kind of back. So again, you can see how it's got the one green blotch. So I'm just going to kind of make sure I cover that. And then, like, again, I'm only going to paint past the halfway point, and I'll fudge this side when I get over there. But that at least gives me the ability. So I'll mask off everything back here. I'll mask off everything on this side, everything back here, everything back here. So it's just the central area open, and I can get a coat of paint on that up around the top of the canopy and the beginning of that. So luckily with this one, the rear fuselage is green. The nose is green. It's just this central section that needs the model. The rest of it is all easily taken care of. So, yeah, that'll be our next step. So, I'm going to go clean the airbrush, and I'm going to get ready to paint the brown on this one. We'll see how it turns out. Stay tuned. And here we go, guys. You can see it now with the brown painted on, so you can see it. You know, you don't notice it with the masking in place, but I'll pull off the little tubes, and you can really start to see how that camo line comes out a nice feathered edge, showing off the blending between two colors. And then I'll try to do this in a way to keep it a bit suspenseful for you. Start pulling off some of these a little bit at a time. Just try to keep it in place as long as possible. Get the bottom one off. So, drum roll please, here she is. There we go. The brown mottling added onto the with the green, so you can clearly see it's not perfect, but this guy here was the one that I painted green and painted the brown over. So there's a little bit of green on the bottom, but in the grand scheme of things, you can't really notice it. And again, you can get a good view of how that edge feathered nicely. See if we can get this thing focused. I think I'm a little too close. There we go. So you can see how the lines lined up nicely here. It's got a nice soft feathered edge. And again, it lined up decently back there. So all in all, I'm pretty happy with how that turned out. Not going to split hairs at the slightest. Definitely looks better than it would have if I tried to freehand any of that. So there we go. And what I'll do at the end is I'll blend with this lower gray color. I'll blend it all together, make it look a little bit more uniform. So next step is going to be getting this side done up. So let's get that done. So same thing. I'm going to try to line up the existing pattern as closely as I can. Get a piece of tape on there, hold that in place. I'll come across, the front one's lined up perfectly. So I want to get a piece of tape on the bottom here. And again, come across to the front, and the front one is damn near perfect. There we go. So I'll use the same blue putty as before. So what you want to do here is you want to pick up the line and keep it as close as you can to the original. And this guy here, I'm going to cover it like, I'm going to cover it like that. So the pattern will be slightly different on this side than on the other side. Just enough to break it up. And then this guy here will come in the front. That's gonna be the same idea. Pick up the pattern back here somewhere. Bring it across. And then ensure full coverage. There we go. There we go. That's how you do that. So now that side there is all ready to get its paint. So again, here we are, other side. You can see that the brown has been painted along with the paper mask, and it's all been blended in quite nicely. So I'll start to remove the little putty sausages, and you'll see how the line is nice and clean there. And then same on this side. Again, you'll see how it seamlessly lines up. We'll start pulling the masking tape off. And there we go. Completed mottling on both sides. So it turned out quite well. So that's how you use the paper masks. Again, first time I've ever done that, and I'm very, very happy with the way that turned out. So you can see how it's a process that definitely works well. And we'll jump back to the Focke-Wulf 198, and I'll show you how I use the little sausages to do the rest of the camel pattern and clean everything up. But there we go, paper masks. Okay, so here we are at the Focke-Wulf 198. As you can see, I've got it all painted. Two-tone gray on the top, light blue gray on the bottom. Now, if you remember from my earlier talkings, this is the one I'm doing. It's got this overspray of green. And the important part, painting the green itself is relatively easy. The interesting part is, if you can see, the green was painted after the fact and was painted around the National Insignia, both the cross and the swastika. So I need to make sure that I have that accurate around the round national markings. And that's not going to be easy without having the markings in place to begin with. So my plan, I'm actually going to use masking tape to recreate a mask or the outline of the National Insignia, and then place that on the model, and then use the putty worms to paint on the green striping and have the National Insignia blanked out. So, pretty simple. I have the decal sheet here. If you look at the instructions, I'm looking for decal number 2 is what I'm going to use. So you find the appropriate one. Here we go. Decal number 2. So I am going to measure it. So hold on, which one am I doing here? Decal number 2. Decal number 2. I'm doing white 12. Okay, white 12. So decal number 2 is 2 inches. So I have my thick piece of masking tape here. So I'm going to run a line across roughly the size. It doesn't have to be perfect. I'm going to cut it out. So that is roughly the thickness. It's just square. That is roughly the thickness of the crosses. Now for the length is roughly 'Which should be equal as the side. There we go. Yeah, we're good. So, what I'm going to do is mark off well, that's random. I was within a fraction of an inch of having 3. And then I'll just copy it over and make a second one. So I'm just going to start off like that. And then I'm going to get this thickness again. Again, it doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to be close enough. Close enough. There we go. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's enough to do all the National Insignias on the main fuselage. The wings, I gotta deal with the wings. I'll deal with the wings later. So, first things first, start on the side that I know I have a picture for, and I'm going to do it roughly, kind of covers up off center of the circle, just past the ledge of that, from just about there to just short of the canopy. So put that about there. So there's the vertical, and then the horizontal one is just more or less centered. So there you go. Again, doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be close enough to make it work. And then on this side, again, balance it so it's going to be just over the line. Just over the line. That looks about right. And then centered. So there we go. Here's the two sides. I'll do the wings. It's only the left wing I have to worry about. The right wing, it doesn't wrap around as well, or at all. Unfortunately, I only have diagrams for the... No, I have diagrams for both sides. I am good. I take back what I just about said. So that's left side. Left side. Right side. Yeah, we're good. Okay. So, another piece of tape. And then my wing decals are decal number 17, which is probably, knowing my luck, nope, it's a little thinner. Just a hair thinner. What about that? So about that. Lower it down. And then the length. The length is about there. So the length, I'll cut that square, just do it this way. I'll cut that out. Cut that out. Cut that out. And then the length is there. Cut all the way across. Like I said, I don't have to be perfectly perfect because there's a bit of a border around the crosses. The green doesn't touch the crosses. There's always a bit of border. So if these maskings are off by even, you know, just a fraction of an inch, not the end of the world, because I'm going to leave a natural border and it'll make up for any of the differences. So this is going to be right along that panel line, starting just shy of the aileron, somewhere about, yeah, that looks good. And then the other one, again, I'm just gonna basically eyeball it and center it, and there you go. Cross on the fuselages, cross on the wing. Now I can lay out my little putty snakes, and I can cover. I'll do the crosses now, just so that they are done. Actually, yeah, it doesn't matter how I do them now because I filled in the centers, so I can just lay them across. So yeah, and then you'll. I'll just paint the somewhere about there, and that kind of comes across to somewhere like there, that kind of comes out along somewhere like there, and then it kind of cuts up into, let's see, cuts right across that corner of the panel line, up into there somewhere, like that, and then this one's a little harder. I'm gonna have to work from the edge of the wing back. Comes from almost the front edge of the wing, across the edge of that, down into this panel line, and then right about there comes up almost vertically. So something like that. So the green will carry up over the fuselage, but I'll tie that in later. I'm just gonna mask off the fuselage itself. And I'll tie into the rest of it later on once I get this done. So that's going to come in about here somewhere, and then it's going to cut across that, and then it's going to cut across the corner like that, something in the neighborhood of that. And then this, as you can see here, this area where the green hits the fuselage lines up almost perfectly here with how the green meets on the fuselage here. So I will actually tie it in together. And it looks like it doesn't go all the way to the top. It just kind of curls up the side. This guy here will come to the cockpit. This one back here will, it's a little blob. And then this guy I'll wrap around the fuselage. So anyways, starting to come together. So there's the first bit of the green. And I'll get ready to start painting that tomorrow. So there you go. So that's how that's gonna lay out. And you can again see how that area there lines up with kinda this area here. And you can always, like I said, go along like I'm doing now with your thumb and just finesse the little putty worms to make sure that it matches. So yeah, I'm happy with that. So stay tuned, we'll get that painted green soon and you'll get a chance to see how that turns out.
And we'll finish up this video here with four pictures, two of the Falkwolf 198-8, where you can see how those green overspray areas are around the decal, as if the green was painted after the decal, even though the decal was applied last. And the two of the pictures of the Falkwolf Door 9 showing how those splotches came out looking okay once all the decals and weathering is put into place. Hopefully this video has been informative and you have a better idea of how to do some fuselage masking for camouflage. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to send them to me in the comment section or via email or however you would like. And thanks for watching. Thank you for watching, guys, and as always, if you are interested in any of the content you see, you can access my website at www.seans-aviation.com. You can see all the latest pictures of aircraft and museums and the build logs of all of my current models and past models on that site. And if you're interested in any of this content, please click the subscribe button here on YouTube to follow more. Thank you very much, and see you guys next time.